editing, possibly one of the most painstaking processes there is to some when it comes to making videos in general. But over the years, I've learned a few tips and tricks to help improve video editing workflow. So without any further ado, these are my 10 tips for faster video editing. Let's get into it. First things first, if I did shoot my videos in a higher resolution such as 4K or possibly just a higher frame rate that my computer struggles to handle when it comes to playback, I'm going to go ahead and proxy those videos. This is just going to create a lower resolution file that is easier for my computer to play back. It will still also export in that same high quality that you shot in it. Secondly, create and use keyboard shortcuts. Whereas there's some things with the mouse that takes two clicks, you can often turn into one with keyboard shortcuts. And whereas two clicks doesn't sound like a whole lot, it does add up over time, and keyboard shortcuts will massively speed up your video editing. Next is add media that you use a lot to your favorites in Premiere Pro. This will really help because if you are using things such as music a lot, sound effects a lot, stock videos a lot, instead of having to go out of Premiere Pro to go and find that media, you can easily favorite it right in Premiere Pro so it stays all right in that one program. Next is create a workspace that works for you. For example, when I'm video editing, I'm using two monitors, so when I'm color grading or something like that, I can have one monitor dedicated to just playback. That's gonna be able to give me a larger timeline, more windows on the bottom to be able to work around with color, but on the top, it's also gonna give me the fact that I can easily preview changes that I'm making on a big display compared to just a little preview box on one monitor. Now, you may not have two monitors, but you can also still change around your workspace to make it work best for how you video edit it. Next is use bins to organize your media when you start a project. Make a bin for A-roll, B-roll, all your sounds, all your music. This will help you find media a lot quicker and help you save a lot of time in the long run. One of the easiest ones, but one of the ones that I think saves the most time, is create presets. For example, I do a shot like this very often, and it has, of course, the same pretty much colors all the time, so I can easily create a color grade preset to drop on shots like this. So I don't have to be sitting there spending a bunch of time color grading over and over again when I could be easily using a preset. It also helps create more consistency throughout your videos and just helps keep your colors looking the same from video to video. If you have a slow computer, if possible, add effects and presets last in your video editing process. Effects and presets can often slow down playback and just make your editing in general slower. Now, if you don't want to do that, for example, with presets or color grades and stuff like that, you can easily add an adjustment layer and put your presets and effects onto there and just turn your adjustment layer off when you are video editing and easily turn it back on when you're ready to export. If you record audio externally and not with your camera, instead of taking the time to sync up that audio with lining up waveforms manually, Premiere Pro can easily automatically sync up the audio for you. Now, it doesn't always get it right, but most of the time it does get it spot on, and this will help save you a lot of time. The next tip actually pertains to when you are shooting your video, and that is plan for your edit. If you don't plan for your edit, it's like someone handing you a puzzle without you knowing what the end result is supposed to look like. Yeah, you may be able to fit all those pieces together, but it's definitely gonna take a lot of the time, and you're gonna have to do a lot of guessing and looking for those select clips that are going to fit together well. Whereas if you know what the end picture is supposed to look like, it's gonna be a lot easier to find those clips that are going to fit together, and most likely you're going to end up with a better product in the end anyways. And finally, the last tip is just practice. Naturally, when you go ahead and practice this once a week, once a day, once every other day, you're naturally going to go ahead and get faster. You're gonna learn those keyboard shortcuts better. You're going to learn more keyboard shortcuts. You're gonna get your own personal workflow down and locked in and ready to go. Like they say, practice makes perfect. That's pretty much it for this one. I'll see you later.